Okay, so on the last video, we were talking about how to purposely flow in the river of life and to ground ourselves when we have a fork in the road. And the fork in the road would be what's called the rushing rapids of thought. Now, if you ever notice a nice river, that its flow and is smooth and is calm. But sometimes the river will get into areas of rocky territory in the river, and the rocks are various sizes, and so the rapids start. You get white waters, and you can get tossed to and fro on your canoe or your river raft as you go through these rapids in the river, and they can be very dangerous, but with the power of thought, they are not dangerous when you use the power of thought. It is just imaginary contrast. So they're not really dangerous. The only danger that is there is if we give reality to the rushing rivers of thought. And so that is just like pulling out our jurisdiction or pulling out an identification card and identifying with the thoughts. And the thought says to us, "Oh, thanks for showing me your identification card. I'm glad you're a citizen. Now I get to do with you whatever I want. So here's an emotion that I want you to feel." And so after we have identified ourselves with the rushing river rapids of thought, where all fear and all depression resides, and that comes from the unconscious animal brain. Now there's two sides of the animal brain. There's a conscious side and there's an unconscious side. That's just another way of saying there is a unconscious female side and there is an unco there is a conscious male side. And we can get into describing that. And I have described it in other videos. So, as we Now, I was talking about this video series and purposely grounding myself at all times. And like I said, I realized, oh, okay. Something is pulling on me to say it's all right to flow into the river of life. Because these are where the pleasant thoughts are. This is where revelation is, new ideas, attaboys, pets, strokes, like, good boy, good boy, make you feel good. These are where all the good feelings are located. And we can enter that river of thought anytime we want also. But we also have the option to get out of all thought altogether. And that is by purposely bringing our attention to our arms, our legs, Mother Nature, the walls if we're inside a building, if we're outside the sunshine. Even when we have our eyes closed, we can give our attention to the back of our eyes, the blackness of the back of our eyes mixed with light swirls and pictures here and there, that imagination. And we can use our peripheral sense to be aware of the birds and the trees and the sky around us and the earth and the water, the wind. So that's called grounding. Grounding is when we purposely stop all thought altogether and we just concentrate on our surroundings, focus on our surroundings. Now, it may take a little bit of time for the thoughts to finally come to a resting point, but it can actually get to the point where you can go in and out of it just like that. Quickly. All I gotta do is look at my guitar sitting on the couch, look at the walls, listen to the birds outside. And I can just sit here and wait for rivers of life thoughts to enter into my mind. And at that point, I could decide whether or not to flow into the river or to remain here in totally grounded in the present moment of now. Or I can go in and out, back and forth between the river of thought and coming back here. Usually this is experienced when you're when you're having nice thoughts and all of a sudden the cat will jump on your chest. This brings you right to the present now of the moment, and your thoughts are interrupted. And so you can start petting your cat, and you can think in the river at the same time. Just like we can think while we're in the river of life at the same time as driving down the road. As being out in the backyard, enjoying the sunshine. So, mainly this video series that I'm making here is to show us how we can purposely create our own reality by channeling our thoughts in the direction that we want to go. And like I said, this whole week I've been purposely practicing being here in the present moment of my surroundings. And I pulled myself out of all thoughts altogether. But like I said, last night I had a desire to enter into thought, to enter into the pleasant sides of thoughts. Because as I was doing for the week, and I was being here, right here now, in the present moment, I was purposely pushing back any pleasant thoughts whatsoever. And so that was raining on my conscience of my Most High. And my Most High was saying, hey, it's all right. It's all right. It was that still small voice that said, it's all right. You can enter into these thoughts. The rivers of thoughts, you can enter into those. Those are the good thoughts where you dream and you plan and you expect and you experience revelatory thoughts on confirmation signs of Mother Nature that you are on the right path, that you made the right decisions. And these thoughts can also describe insights as to how things and mechanisms work on the earth, how organizations work, how private maritime law works in its deepest, deepest levels, and its deepest, deepest revelations, and how the legal world works in its deepest, deepest revelations. So, now this book right here, Healing Back Pain, is the second book that John wrote on the subject. But he has an up-to-date book that I hear on the Howard Stern Show that is much more revelatory. So I'll be interested in checking that book out here sometime. And I don't have the name of it on the tip of my tongue right now, but really all I got to do is just go onto Google and just type in John E. Sarno, list of books. And let's see what the YouTube brings up. The Mind-Body Connection. Okay, so let's 2010, so healing back pain, the mind body prescription. So this might be his latest book. Let me see. I think that's the one that Howard Stern said. Let's see if we can find a copyright on it. Healing the Body, Healing the Pain. Okay, so he's general with the pain here. This book had to do with back pain, but all pain in the body is the same. So let's see if I can look inside the book. This would have to be his latest book because it says, mentions 2020. Seeing if there, I'm on Amazon.com right now. Ah, here we are. Copyright 1999. First printing 1999. And this one was 1991. Okay, so this is 1991. 1999 for that one. I just pressed on the picture of the book. The Divided Mind. Let's see what year this one is made. Copyright. And I'll put this link in the description below. Look inside. Front cover. The hardcover edition of this book was published in 2006. Okay, so that one's 2006. So I just remember that so that's 2006 and this one's Mind Over Back Pain. This one might be the newest back pain book, because it looks like these books might be lined up in order of copyright. Now, I can sense my back is wanting to get with repressed emotions. Published in 1984. Okay, so that must be his first book here, first back book. Alright, so we just do it like that. So, I'll just put this description in the video below. And, so I'll end this video just to do that. Alright.